Olivia's Birds, Saving the Gulf by Olivia Bowler. Birds are fascinating, intriguing, and unique creatures. Some birds are colorful and pretty to look at. Other birds, like the chickadee, are so friendly that they will eat right out of your hand. There are lots of different types of birds. Some are all around you, in trees, on the tops of telephone poles, and even on your roof. You may not notice the birds around you, but there are lots of them right outside your window. You don't have to travel anywhere to look for them. For example, the graceful barn swallow lives in the crevices of buildings and on the sides of schools. They can usually be found dancing in soccer fields or meadows. If you take a look around, you might catch a glimpse of a white-breasted nuthatch climbing a tree upside down. Which birds do you see outside your window? Did you know that birds learn how to fly from their parents? Bird parents will nudge the babies off the nest. The chicks will either fall or fly out of the tree. If they fall, the parents will swoop them back up until they learn how to fly. Some birds can't fly, like penguins and the kiwi from New Zealand. But most birds are amazing flyers. Songbirds fly in a flutter pattern. They flutter and then they close their wings before fluttering again. Vultures fly in circles looking for prey. Ducks and waterfowl flap their wings very hard and never take a break. Their way of flying looks like it hurts. There is no other animal equipped just like birds. Even the bat can't fly as well or aerodynamically as bird can. Birds are flying elegance. Most birds live in trees, and where are there lots of trees? In woods and forests. Some of the best bird watching can be done in a forest, far away from civilization. If you sit still, birds will certainly come out of hiding. Be sure to bring your binoculars and a camera. And don't just look up. I once found a hummingbird nest on the ground of a wooded area. Imagine yourself sitting in a boat, listening to the pouring rush of water as it moves gently downstream. Doesn't that sound nice? Well, some birds think it's nice too. Many birds live near lakes, streams, and oceans. They need to nest there in order to survive. It takes over 1,000 years for coastal birds to adapt to a new environment. That's really a long time. Some birds do the most interesting, unusual things. Whether it's their curious call or the strange shape of their bill, or perhaps their unique role in our environment. Some birds don't seem like birds at all. What do you think of first when you hear birds of prey? Feisty falcons clutching their lunch in their sharp talons? Or perhaps what comes to mind is our nation's bird, the bald eagle, standing proudly with our flag? Some birds are hunters and can be very aggressive. That's just their nature. They need to eat and live, too. If you want to watch these birds, it's best to stay 20 feet away and use a scope or a pair of binoculars. If you happen to find yourself near one of their nests, don't panic. Put your hands down by your side and back away slowly. Did you know that all baby birds are born kind of naked? It's true. Birds develop in 4 stages. In the first stage, chicks have very dark feathers that are used for camouflage and warmth. They grow head feathers, chest feathers, and their first wing feathers in the second stage. In the 3rd stage of development, birds grow more wing feathers and tail feathers for balance. By the 4th stage, birds have grown their flight feathers and are ready to take to the skies. You can tell a lot about an adult bird by its feathers. Male birds are more colorful than females. They use their feathers for showing off and attracting mates. Female birds have duller feathers that act like camouflage. The mother birds guard the nest and protect their chicks. Even though people are working hard to protect birds and other animals, we are still doing things that can hurt them. As a result, some of our world's most amazing creatures have disappeared or are dying out. Many species of birds are endangered, threatened, or extinct. Bird habitats are being destroyed to build condos, hotels, and other buildings, and by overfishing, pollution, pesticides, and water drainage. If that happens, birds that stay in one place for their whole lives, like the island brown kiwi, have nowhere to live. The good news is that hard work and dedication can save birds. Bald eagles used to be in danger. It took a lot of hard work and conservation efforts, and now our nation's bird is only slightly threatened. But there are still many birds in trouble. The bad news is that a lot of animals are still in danger of being completely wiped out. In April 2010, my grandparents told me about a giant oil spill that had happened in the Gulf of Mexico, deep under the water. The oil was going to hurt all kinds of marine animals that live there, including birds like pelicans that have just come off the endangered species list. I got really upset. My first memory of birds is of the brown pelicans and the great blue herons that live in Alabama. My granny and granddad would take me fishing and show me those beautiful birds. Who was going to save them? I ran right upstairs and wrote a letter to Audubon. I told them that I was willing to help and I wanted to make a difference for those birds. I wanted to be their voice. Audubon read my letter and said they'd be happy to accept my help. Since I like to draw birds, I decided I would donate bird paintings to people who contributed money to Audubon's Gulf cleanup campaign. Slowly, we spread the word online and the first donation came in. I was thrilled that someone wanted to help out. My first thought was, I just took a first step for those birds. After that, the donations kept pouring in. We got 500 requests for paintings in the first month. Since starting the Save the Gulf campaign, I have spoken in Washington, D.C. on behalf of clean energy. I also visited Project Puffin, where I got to hold some tern chicks and ended up with endangered poop. And I have been able to spread the word about animal preservation and the TEDx conventions on television, on the radio, and in magazines. The message I keep telling everyone is that all animals are special and important to our ecosystem. We need to work together to protect them. Imagine if 100 years from now, children wouldn't get to see the variety of beautiful creatures on this planet. We can't let that happen. My whole life has been connected to nature, and this is the only Earth we've got. We can't move to another planet, so we have to try to fix Earth. We only have one chance to do it. If I were president of the United States of America, I would make regulations for fishing companies to limit the amount of fishing. I would stop deforestation and create a tree planting day. Whoever plants the most trees will get a prize. I will encourage people to get together and adopt animals from shelters instead of buying pets from stores. Also, I would make sure that we all used cleaner energy to preserve our Earth. We need to put the eco back in our economy. Even though I'm not the president, I know I can make a difference. And so can you. Kids can do important things to preserve our Earth, such as build a bird feeder, put out unprocessed bird seed or sunflower seeds in your yard to feed birds, set up a recycling group in your school or house, cut down on paper consumption, recycle every day, compost eggshells, banana peels, orange peels, and other food garbage. It will turn into dirt that you can use to plant trees. Make sure to tell everybody what you are doing to save our environment. Spread the word. Kids can definitely make a difference, and I'm here to prove it. Throughout my fundraiser, many kids from all over the world have contacted me looking for ways to help. Some, like me, have made artwork, while others have participated in walkathons. We are the future generation, and even though one person can make a difference, together we can change our planet. Thank you to everyone who is working to help our environment. For more information about birds and wildlife conservation, contact the following organizations: the National Audubon Society, National Wildlife Federation, the Nature Conservancy, Sierra Club, Project Puffin, and the Cornell Ornithology Lab. Thank you.